In this lab demonstration, we'll be using customer-managed encryption keys with cloud storage and Cloud KMS. The Cloud KMS, or Key Management Service, allows you to manage encryption keys on Google Cloud. Encryption keys are created by Cloud KMS and managed by you in the same manner you would manage them on-premises. Using Cloud KMS, we can generate, use, rotate, and destroy AES-256 symmetric encryption keys for direct use by all of our cloud services. So the objectives of this demonstration are to manage keys and encrypt data using Cloud KMS. We'll create keyrings and crypto keys to enable us to do this. We'll set a default encryption key for a storage bucket, encrypt an object with a Cloud KMS managed key, and rotate encryption keys. So far in my project, I've created a cloud storage bucket, and I've created three simple text files that we'll use to demonstrate encryption. I'll upload the first file to my bucket now. And we can see that it's encrypted with a Google managed key because I haven't set up Cloud KMS yet. In order to use Cloud KMS, I need to create a keyring and at least one crypto key. Keyrings are useful for grouping keys. You can group them by environment, for example, or some other conceptual grouping. For this lab, I'll create a keyring called Lab Keyring and some keys called Lab Key 1 and Lab Key 2. To make it easier to run some commands in a moment, I'll set these up as environment variables. Now I'll create my keyring using gcloud kms keyrings create. Next, using my new keyring, I'll create a crypto key named lab key 1. Now I'll create another crypto key called lab key 2. I can see my keyring and keys in the cloud console under Security Key Management. Here's my keyring. And here are my two managed keys. I can use the gsutil kms encryption command to show me the default encryption key for my cloud storage bucket. Right now, I haven't set a default encryption key, and that means that all data in the bucket will be encrypted by a Google managed encryption key instead. To use my new keys with my cloud storage bucket, I first need to authorize the cloud storage service account so that it has permission to access my keys. I can do this with the gsutil kms authorize command, specifying my project and the name of my key. I'll repeat the command for the second key. And now I can set a default key for my bucket. That means that new objects written to my bucket will be encrypted with this key. I'll use the gsutil kms encryption command, specifying the name of my key, and the bucket. I can check that I've set the default encryption key by using the gsutil kms encryption command again. Now, objects that I copy into my bucket will be encrypted with my new key. Objects that were written to the bucket prior to adding or changing the default key will of course remain encrypted with the previous encryption method. I can now see in the cloud storage browser that the first file was encrypted with the original Google managed key, and the second file was encrypted with my customer managed key. Next, I'll demonstrate how we can encrypt an individual object with a Cloud KMS key, as opposed to using the default key. This can be useful if you want to use a different key from the default key set on the bucket, or if you don't have a default key set on the bucket. We can do this by passing a specific flag to the gsutil command. So here we're running a normal gsutil copy command to move file3.txt into my bucket, but I'm telling gsutil to use a specific encryption key for this object by using this flag. In the cloud storage browser, I can hover over the encryption method of my files, and it will give me some information about which key is being used. I can also view this information using gsutil ls minus capital L. Finally, let's demonstrate key rotation with Cloud KMS. In Cloud KMS, a key rotation is triggered by generating a new version of a key and marking that version as the primary version. Each key has a designated primary version at any point in time, which Cloud KMS will use to encrypt data. After rotating a key, its previous key versions, which are no longer primary, are neither disabled or destroyed and remain available for decrypting data. First, we'll set up some automatic key rotation. By providing a rotation schedule, Cloud KMS will automatically rotate your keys for you. In the key management section of the Cloud Console, I can view the details of my key and set the rotation period. So right now, I'll set this rotation period to 30 days. We can also manually rotate keys using the Cloud Console. Let's do this for Lab Key 2. All I need to do is click the Rotate Key button, and then click Rotate to confirm. I'll now see that I have two versions of this key, with version 2 being the primary version. Note that using key rotation like this does not re-encrypt already encrypted data with the newly generated key version. If you suspect unauthorized use of a key, you should re-encrypt the data protected by that key, and then disable or schedule destruction of the prior key version. We can easily disable or destroy a key from the Cloud Console, but note that if you destroy a key that has encrypted existing objects, you will be unable to recover that data, and you will still be charged for the storage of those objects until you delete them. That concludes this lab demonstration.